Oshia Malele, and I'm a mine manager.
I'm working as a mine at Section 49.
I'm a chief boss. I'm a safety officer at Bramsprit Mine.
I'm a chief geologist.
And I'm a senior manager of business planning.
We embarked on women in the mining industry quite a few years ago. It's part of our incentives. It's part of our, how we manage the business.
When I started here, there were very few mining women, especially in the coal face.
Because the work on the ground needs you to be physically fit. Because you do a lot of labor work, you do a lot of walking, and if you're not fit for that, you might not be able to survive.
We had quite a problem to get women to actually pass the physical test. Initiative then started where we put a program together, the so-called boot camp.
The boot camp, as hard as it was, but then it helped. My body was stiff, I couldn't walk the following day, but then I told myself that, you know what, I'm doing this for my future.
You do a bit of exercising, they check your heart rates, they check whether you can survive going up and down stairs.
Far over 90% of the people that actually went to the boot camp and be mentally prepared were actually able to pass the test and actually be able to go and actually start working in the mines.
When lifting those cables, I'm thinking like, I lifted the 30 kgs at medical, so I can do it even here underground.
We are very privileged to be in this industry, and we're privileged with the opportunities that we have. There's a lot of women in Sasol that are doing it for themselves.
You know, like they say, what Tintin Five, what Tintin Bogot.
There's actually women mining forums and mentorship programs that are available for women.
The new generation mines are now gender equal, and for that reason, we see a lot more of women that will now find it much easier to come into mining and actually be part of our mines going forward.